colors, a lot of people struggle, and that includes myself. So to help me, and obviously to help you, today I want to show you my favorite tool that helped me when it comes to pick up colors. It's called Coolorus, and I will give you a little demonstration of it, and even a little bit later tell you how you can get it for free. So this is the Coolorus. It's that little wheel that you see, and it's a plugin to replace the color picker of Photoshop, which is this one that you already that you always have to double click to make it appear. And just for that, it's already a plus. The Coolorus will stay in place in front of your computer when you're drawing at all times, seeing the colors all the time. It's going to be easier for you to pick up the colors. For the Similitude, you can see that they almost have all the same features, except that the colors have a lot more features. But you have the color wheel, which is all around it here, and you have the color slider, which we have here, and the color picker here, and you can put it to either the triangle or the square, depending on your preferences. Now, when it starts to change, it's these features that you have here. So you obviously have the foreground and background color, which is the foreground here and the background here. But you have beside this all the color harmonies, which right now I'm on the monochromatic, means that I have only one color. But that's what I'm going to pick up on the complementary scheme. Now I have the two, and they will follow in front of each other, telling me exactly what's the complementary of the color that I'm picking. And for those who struggle with color, that will help you a lot. And you have the complementary as much as the triadic and analogous and a few of them like this. So you'll be able to play with the colors and know exactly the results that you want to have with those color harmony. So just for that, it's already a big plus. Also, you'll be able to customize the wheel by just clicking on it and pressing on the minus. You can see that it's going to get in a smaller chunk, depending on what you want. And all the color sliders will have the same thing. If you have to click on it and simply press the minus, it will get in a smaller chunk or bigger chunk, depending on what you want. You simply have to press the plus, or in my case, the shift plus, and it will go back to the smooth color wheel, as you can see right now. Also, the Colorist will give you a little bit of the color slider, but all the different. So you have the RGB, the HSV, which is mostly the one that painter will prefer. For sure is the one I prefer. You have all the colors, and you can play with the saturation and the value of that color at the same time. But you also have the lab, the CMYK, and the grayscale, obviously. You will also have the mixer. And if I click on the mixer, then you'll have a few of them. You have the scheme, blender, shades and tones, the coloristry, and the swatches. And if you click on the little icons here at the bottom, you'll be able to make them appear or disappear, as much as by clicking and dragging, be able to make them switch. Now the scheme is really, really cool, because depending on the color harmony that you have, let's say I'm on the complementary here, and I press on the auto sample here, I'll be able to switch, and then it's going to give me a blending between the two of them. And the blender will give me a blender between the foreground and the background color. So I'll be able to actually pick up some colors that are from the scheme. And obviously the blender will change depending on the colors that I have in front of them here, from the background and the foreground color. Then you have the shade and tone will give you this color that you have. Each time that I pick a color, it will give me the shade that I can have from really high to really low in terms of value. And the color history, which will give me each color that I'm picking at all the time and give me an history of it. And finally, the swatches, which I can just simply take a swatch and drag it to have it there. And therefore, I'll be able to make myself a selection of swatches that I like. You will also have, for the people that like to use text, I'm thinking maybe people that like to put text on the illustration, or just graphic designers, or even web designers. So by clicking just text, usually you have to change the color here, change the color there, and then you're like, all right, I'm going to put some text. Well, with the Coolorus, if you go into settings, and if you put just the effect shape and text, then you will have simply to have to go on your layer, and not even to double click on it and usually have it selected at this time. You simply have to be on the layer by clicking on the layer, and then I can simply have to change the color, and Colorist will give me the color that I'm picking each time on my text. So that can be a really cool feature for people that actually use text. And that feature will also work if you're using shapes. So if I'm making a shape here and I just decide to change it, it will do the same thing. I just have to be on the layer. I don't have to double click on it and then change it. I can simply now change it by moving my Colorist. So you can save a lot of time by doing this as well. Now, my favorite tool that Colorist gives is actually the gamut mask that you have right here. And by clicking on the gamut mask, it's going to give you a selection of different masks that you can have, from triangle to square, round, got a few of them. And they're all fully customizable. So I can click here on the edit mask, and I'll be able, therefore, to move each of the points. Let's say I would have something that's towards the gray in the middle with the red and the purple blue, and then something a little bit more saturated for the yellow here. And then I'll be able to actually move it if I want to, as much as rotate it to define the gamut mask that I want. And then just simply click OK. And a gamut mask basically is a mask that you put over the color wheel, and then you can simply have a smaller selection of the colors, making sure that you don't get lost and don't create pizzas as well when you're painting, by having a more refined or more small palette of color to create your illustration. That can be really, really practical. And that's in a nutshell how Colorist is working. Now, for those of you who want to have the plugin for free, I'll put a link below. Colorist gives you a 14 days trial to actually try the color wheel. But I assure you that after 14 days, if you try it, you will want to keep it. So if you want it at 40% off, which will make it $10 instead of $14, you can have actually a link on the Academy, as well as mini video where I actually show you how to use the color harmony, as much as videos on how the color gamut mask works. So if you're interested for that as well, I'll put a link below. You simply have to click on the link for the Digital Painting Academy. Don't forget to like, share, or comment below this video. And if you really want to take your digital painting to the next level, come check out the Academy, where we offer in-depth tutorial, step-by-step lessons, exercises, live workshops, premium resources, and a world-class community of inspired digital painting like yourself, ready to help you and support whenever you need it. You just have to click on the link below this video or on the button to find more. And until next time, happy painting.